The app logos, they didn't really change logo design. It's more that logos have become much more important since apps dominate our lives so much. Sciences Po. The first recommendation I present, and I think it's the most important one, is that the app icon has to be a distinctive sign. It has to be able to function as a trademark. So what does it mean? When an app icon is too simple, when the logo is just a dot, a square, a circle, something too basic, it will not be able to function as a trademark. So that doesn't make a very strong app logo in that case. So the second recommendation is that the app logo should not be descriptive. The logo should not visually describe the services offered by the company or by the app. It means that anything like a fork for restaurant services, a bed for hotel services, or a cloud for cloud services should in principle be avoided, because you will not be able to monopolize it as a trademark. So it will be a relatively weak logo right from the start. The third recommendation concerns colors. I recommend that people make extensive use of colors because they are part of a distinctive image of a brand. At the same time, you should be careful because there are certain tendencies to use specific colors for certain types of services. You can think of green for communication apps, yellow for taxi apps. If you choose that color, it means you're not very distinctive, and so from a trademark perspective you have weaker protection. The fourth recommendation concerns the use of initials, of single letters. What a lot of people do, because they're limited by the space, they choose the first letter of their original trademark, and that way they think the consumer will understand that it concerns their hallmark. From a trademark perspective, that is not a good choice, because mostly in most countries in the world, it's impossible to monopolize, so to say, single letters as a trademark. They are mostly excluded as a trademark. So if you choose that as an app, again, you end up with a weak trademark. The fifth recommendation may seem an obvious one. When you already have a good logo, why not use it as an app logo? Very often people choose different logos to underline that they have an app or they have an online presence. And maybe in the past that was something special, but this has become so common that I think it's a better solution to simply choose an existing logo if that's already a good one. The sixth recommendation concerns prior rights. When you design an app, you have to make sure that the elements you use are not owned by someone else. So it means you have to do some research to make sure that other people will not attack you based on prior rights and claim all kinds of things when you have finally adopted your logo. The seventh recommendation also concerns rights, but it's about your own rights. When you have an app, when you have an app icon finally chosen, you have to make sure that you own the rights to that logo. Very often people outsource the design. That can be to a company, or that can be a member of the family or a friend. So you have to make sure that those people transfer their rights to you or your company to make sure that you don't run into trouble afterwards. And the eighth recommendation is you should register your app logo. A lot of people forget that. You choose a logo, but what do you do with it? If you want to have a trademark, you have to file a trademark application. The ninth condition is about continuity of your trademark use. Most trademark systems in the world, they require that you use the trademark as registered. So when you change your app logo, it means you're not using the trademark as registered, and it means you may lose your rights. And the 10th and final recommendation is about technological change. And we are all used to apps with the rounded edges. And I think that may change in the future because those shapes are simply imposed by the operating systems now and are not part of the design that is wanted by app designers. So be careful when you file a trademark that you don't file it in that particular shape. Another important point of technological change is that we may see in the future that apps are not static anymore, but that companies are allowed to use small films or at least moving images. And that will open a whole new chapter in app icon design.